tried to show you, but you ignore the signs. Guess we've been strangers for all this time. We just finished rolling out our latest major update across all of our 3D clothing mockups. Some highlights of these updates include new dynamic poses and hanging models, a rack for the neon light preset, a customizable generative background in a brutalist style, seamless loops integrated into the walk and wind animations, the possibility of adding your own custom fabric textures, and the 3D source files for Marvelous Designer or Clo3D are now included with the extended commercial license. If you already have one of these mockups, the workflow is still the same as version 1.0, with some small changes outlined in the user guide. So you can skip this tutorial and log into your account to access your updated files for free. Firstly, fully unzip the zip file, then download and install Blender to open the mockup. Open the design file in Photoshop or Photopea and add your designs within the guides, then save. Back in Blender, switch to the Shading tab and select the model. If you don't see these controls centered, just go to View, Frame All. Click on the folder icon and relink the design file to update your designs on the material. You can click on this gizmo and these icons to navigate around the garment to check your design. Uncheck the scene collection for now if it gets in the way. Here you can change colors and remove labels. In the advanced section, you can add your own fabric textures to the main parts of the garment and neck or hem areas separately. In the clothing collection, you can switch between different poses and animations. You can change the position and rotation of a model by making sure it's selected, then changing these values in the object properties. To change animation speed or direction of rotation animations, make sure you're in the layout view so the timeline is visible. Then select the model and you'll see the rotation keyframes appear. To make an animation faster, drag the keyframes on the end to the left or to the right to slow it down. You can match the timeline to the new speed in the output properties by changing the frame range end. To change direction of the rotation, move the timeline to the last keyframe and change the value in the object properties. If I change this to 360 instead of negative 360 and click on the keyframe icon twice until the value is highlighted yellow again, the rotation will be in the opposite direction. Instead of a constant speed, you can make the animation accelerate and decelerate by selecting all the keyframes, right-clicking, and changing the interpolation mode to Bezier. Note that the walk and wind animations are seamlessly looped over the default timeline frame range. You can switch and combine different lighting presets by simply checking on what you want affecting the scene. The color and brightness of any light can be changed in its material properties. The neon light has a slightly different process to change it. Go to its material properties and change the emission color and emission strength under the volume section. To customize the rest of the scene, check on what you want visible in the scene collection. The neon light rack uses the same preset as the neon light in the lighting collection. The color of the studio backdrop can be changed in its material properties by changing the base color. The generative brutalist background can be customized in its modifier properties. By moving around these empty objects, you can easily control the open space in the scene. If you want to change the color of the empty background, adjust the color ramp in the World tab. Otherwise, if you want a completely transparent background, make sure transparent is checked in the render settings under the film section. There are over 70 camera presets, not including the variations that have depth of field built in. All you have to do to switch to a camera is click on the green camera icon next to a preset. If nothing happens in the viewport, make sure that the camera view is active. You can adjust the speed of camera animations the same way that we adjusted the rotation keyframes earlier. In the render settings, keep the max samples at 4096. All you need to do is adjust the noise threshold value to optimize render quality and time. The project's default value is 0.02. This gives me a good quality image with minimal noise in a reasonable render time in most cases. The highest value I would go is 0.2 and the lowest would be 0.002. If you want to denoise a static image render, check Use Nodes in the Compositing tab, and the image will get denoised much better than the default denoise option. If you need to denoise animation, I recommend using Super Image Denoiser. It's a free add-on that'll save you hours of time if you need to use a high noise threshold value to get something rendered out fast without the noise. You can adjust the resolution in the Output Properties tab, as well as the frame rate and length of animation. If you have a transparent background, choose the PNG file format with RGBA color. Otherwise, if you're using the backdrop or a solid color, you can leave it on RGB. To render an image, go to Render, Render Image, and Save. To render animation, make sure you set a location in the Output Properties and go to Render, Render Animation. This will render individual frames which you need to stitch together in compositing software like DaVinci Resolve, which is free. To composite in DaVinci Resolve, open it up and start a new project. Match the frame rate to the frame rate used in your Blender project by going to File, Project Settings, and change the timeline frame rate, then save. Next, change the layout at the bottom to Media and navigate to where your animation frames are saved. To create a shortcut to a folder where you can easily access your renders, right-click and add a new location. Once you're in the folder with your frames, click these three dots and change the frame display mode to sequence and drag this file into the media pool. Switch over to the edit view and drag this clip into the timeline, then switch to deliver view to adjust the final export settings. Choose a location for your final video and stick with the default settings for standard MP4. If you want to export with a transparent background, choose GoPro Cineform RGB 16-bit. Add to render queue and render all. You can leave a comment on the video if you have any questions not covered. I'm also available through the contact form on my website or directly via email if you need any additional assistance.